those of you who have joined us early on today, I'm Angela Williams. I'm a member of the Victoria Accordion Club Band, and I'm also the Vice President. I'll be your MC for today. But first, I would like to introduce our President, Carol Briante, who is going to say a few welcoming opening words. Thank you.
I want to put this forward because I prepared a lengthy speech. Okay. First of all, I'd like to welcome you all to Victorian Accordion Club's anniversary celebration of 20 years. And Shoal has been our home since 2017, and Shoal staff has provided this venue for practices, concerts, Oktoberfest, and for today's special event. And I would like to thank Jennifer Van Ness, who is the manager of Shoal Center, Linda Lightbody, Community Services Coordinator, Emma Eaton, the Activity Administrator Assistant, and our chef Karen Taylor and the kitchen staff that have provided refreshments and cake for this afternoon. To prepare for this speech today, I had to do some historical research, and I referred to a really reliable source, Ante Milner, because he was here when this club first started. And he told me he was waiting for a bus in front of the Bay Center in downtown Victoria. And he saw a man with a very large suitcase. And he asked, "Is that an accordion?" And then mine replied, "How do you know? Do you play?" And Ante said, "Yes." So David Mazoff replied, "Follow me." And he took him to the Edelweiss Club. And they went up that side stairs to the upstairs game slash bar, where five other men waited for them. There was long, tall John Fear, Arnie Kren, Robert Hildebrand, and two local businessmen, Carl and Martin Hurt, our main suppliers in Victoria for anything accordion. Their purpose was to start an accordion club and band. And following that initial meeting, they put an ad in the Times Colonist asking for accordionists and accordion enthusiasts to join. At that very first official meeting, the only woman that showed up was one and only my dear friend, Daphne McDonald. And she not knowing what to expect, left her accordion in the trunk of her car and brought no music. And then she was asked to audition. And she had to audition in front of the band leader, Irv Lang. And she played the only song that came to her mind at that point was Life in Finland Woods. And after several minutes of careful consideration, and Irv said, "You're in." By 2003, there were 54 members. Irv Lang was the leader, and that band was playing at many community events in and around the Capital Region District. They hosted two international festivals that attracted accordionists from BC, Alberta, and the US, specifically from Oregon, Washington State, and California. When Irv retired, Patty Foreman and Ron Serra, they're both here today, took over as band leaders. When Patty stepped away, VAC was fortunate to have on tap the energetic Ron Serra as our band leader. And Ron does a tremendous amount of work. Our set lists, our performances, our background check, our rhythm, our sound check, technical setup, takedown, and yes, he directs us musically. He introduces new music, he catches our mistakes. And he still has us playing all over the CRD, Vancouver Island, Oktoberfest, Christmas carols, local music festivals, the Vancouver Christmas Market, and our infamous trip to Leavenworth, International Accordion Festival, Leavenworth, Washington. Now COVID has taken its toll in our club. Over the past 2 years, we were not able to get together physically to play music, but we did it via Zoom, postings to YouTube, and thanks to our technical wizard, Angela Williams. And today, we are playing for you in person to celebrate 20 years of music together, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Some of our very favorite songs, the ones that we've known for many, many years. So this next one is called La Cumparsita. Have you ever heard of it? Yeah, La Cumparsita Tango. Let's give it a try. Thank you. lovely waltz that we have been playing for many, many years, and we have about 17 parts in this song. Is it there something like that? Yeah, something like that. And so we have enough people to play each part. I hope so, anyway. Okay, this is called Melody of Love. Jambalaya has been in the bars and all kinds of places for 1,000 years. So it's a good Southern country song. So we're going to play, well, Southern Alabama or something like that. Wait, Jambalaya. Thank you. we're going to play Funiculi Funicula, the Italian version.
Thank you.
Anniversary. Okay, what was it called? Fly Me to the Moon, and the other one was called?
Blue Moon.
Blue Moon, yes.
Okay.
You do get cake. We'll let you have it this time. Okay, this next one, I shouldn't tell you what this one is either, but we're going to do it anyway. It's called A White Sport Coat and a Pink Carnation. I think you might have heard this one. It's a universal language, and it's just, in my view, awesome. Okay, isn't that cool? Anyway, music. This next song we're going to do is a lovely song called Petite Boutique. It's a nice little waltz. Thank you. We just learned this one a little bit ago. And Angela put this up on the website, right? On the thing, and it's got, was it 10 million views? It's not, well, okay, 10. It's called Blue Tango.
Thank you.
Okay, now, thank you very much. We have a whole bunch of good-looking people out there. I know that you all are. And so we're going to play Hey, Good Lookin'.
Especially Floyd.
Where's Floyd? Stand up, Floyd.
Stand up, Floyd, right there.
There he is. Oh, I can see why you thought that, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. So.
Oh, and Victor, too.
Where are all the girls? I mean, you know. Stick with the oldies now, okay, because these are songs that everybody knows. Have you ever heard of Satchmo? Anybody heard of Satchmo? No? Oh, sure. You're way old. No, you're way younger.
That's how you carry your accordion.
Blueberry Hill. Here's
thank you.
Okay, another down home, down country style song called Cotton Fields at Home. Yes, you know that one. Yeah, here we go. What's his name? Frankie Yankovic.
That's the guy, right?
Yeah, Frankie Yankovic. He was a very famous symphony orchestra accordion player, wasn't he? Yeah, that's the guy. Okay, Julida Polka. Here we go.
Thank you.
trust Sam to do that. He's got to do that. Okay, that's right. Okay, we're going to do a lovely song that Engelbert Humperdinck. Remember that dude? Engelbert Humperdinck? Yes. He did this one called Blue Spanish Eyes. Yeah, only he was Italian or what? I don't know. He's American. He was Welsh. Is that right? No. Okay. And Tom Jones and Engelbert were Welsh. I didn't know that. Okay, he will sing Blue Spanish Eyes in that case.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you so, so much. God bless Ukraine.
Oh.